In the automotive and aerospace industries, there is a big push for high accuracy parts. My name is Matthew Williams. I work at AMRC. Everything in here is to do with carbon fibre and automation. I work on the pick and place robot cell to move carbon fibre plies accurately and with speed to support the demand for engineering in the automotive and aerospace industries. The brackets that initially came on this robot were L brackets. Over a prolonged use, the brackets have slowly starting to bend, and eventually that gripper won't pick up the ply from the conveyor anymore. So I needed to create something that was stiff but flexible. I needed a shape that would be able to suit both of those things. And I've done 5 or 6 iterations. Initially, we wanted to change the aluminium weld for something that could be a bit more springy. So we thought 3D printing, that'd be brilliant. So we made the same as what we had, but it flexed too much. From that stage of development, we created this current shape tool, but we found that the noise that was being produced was too high to be in a working environment. We needed to add a silencer system, which needed a bigger bracket. So we thickened up where the supports were, and we also made it out of durable material. It can take quite a lot of stress and force, and it flexes back again afterwards. Works perfectly. With all the iterations that I've done, if I had to machine each iteration of those, that would have taken 2 or 3 weeks. Whereas if it takes 6 hours to 3D print one, and we're doing it in a time where we're not relying on it to work, it's not wasting any time. The printers that we've got here are really good because they are here. I could literally walk across the road, just 3D print another iteration, and apply them straight away.